Hey YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator course called Illustrator Essentials. You can check it out on bringyourownlaptop.com. If you want to follow along with this video, there's exercise files, okay? Those are free to download. You can go and download those and there'll be a link in the description, okay? So you can play along. One last thing is there's a cheat sheet as well. So there is a PDF you can download from bringyourownlaptop.com. Look for resources, okay? It's a free PDF. You can download it, print it up, stick it next to the computer while you're doing these videos. All right, enjoy the video. Bye now. Hi there. In this video, we're going to redraw the new eHarmony logo. Okay, and we're going to learn a couple of ways of doing it. We're going to use the curvature tool for one, and then we'll go off and use kind of more symmetry and actual shapes to build it. We'll use the shape builder and the eyedropper tool, and we'll be awesome. All right, let's go and do it now in Adobe Illustrator. All right, so let's open up in our exercise files under logo redraw folder. There's one called number 4, and then it's called eHarmony. Okay, first thing I wanted, there's going to be a couple of ways we can do this. I'll show you two, there's probably 10. Let's go for just physically redrawing it. We're going to use the curvature tool instead of the pen tool because it's pretty good for perfect roundy things like this. I'm going to zoom in. I'm using Command Plus on my keyboard. Spacebar to kind of move around. Command Plus on a PC, it's Control Plus. Cool. So the crash course for the curvature tool, if you've forgotten, click once, you get curves, all sorts of cool curves. If you double click and double click and double click, you get corners. So let's grab the curvature tool again. And this is a corner because it goes in and changes. It's like a change of direction. So double click. Okay, over here, I click once for a corner. Okay, and when it's not until I kind of like start, I'm not dragging, I'm just moving my mouse out that it starts doing its lovely curve. Okay, here again, this is not a corner, okay? It's the kind of the start of the straight here. So I'm gonna double click and double click and double click. And it's just here, the kind of apex of this curve here that I wanna click once for a corner. Back to here, this is a corner again, remember? So double click, actually, go back, just click it once. Now listen to me. Okay, so that is using the curvature tool. Curvature tool is pretty handy for, yeah, especially things that need to be like really perfect. Pen tool, if you ever play with it, that's a tough one to do that. Now to slice this stuff through, we're just gonna use the line segment tool. And this is where it gets a little bit just kind of hacky. So we'll show you a second way in a bit. So with the line tool, if I draw a line, it goes anywhere. Okay, but if I hold shift while I'm dragging it, I get it in perfect angles, okay? And in this case, I want this one, which is 45 degrees. Okay, so I'm dragging this nice and long. Grab my black arrow, I'm gonna line it up. You, my friend, line up there. And this one here, I'm gonna copy and paste it. I'm gonna grab you and get you to line up. Now what I can do is I'm gonna move it down there. I'm gonna grab this part of it and try and get it to snap to that point, okay? Now if yours is not snapping, just check that you've got view and you've got smart guides on. I'm going to select both of these, copy and paste it. Actually, what I'll do is you could rotate it now, right? Holding shift. Okay, because remember it rotates in perfect circles, and I could just grab this line, try and get it to bang up against that one. Okay, not bad. So another way you could do it though, just want to show you, is with it selected, I can go to object and go to reflect. Okay, and vertical, turn preview on and make a copy. Okay, so instead of okay, which will just reflect that one across, I want to make a copy at the same time. Either way, I think the second way was the longer way. All right, so there's my kind of rough guy. Now I need to get the color segments. So I've got it all selected with my black arrow. Now we're going to go to my super duper favorite tool, the shape builder tool. And I need to do a couple of things. One is let's trim off these lines. So hold down the option key on a Mac or the alt key on a PC and just drag through them, clicking, holding and dragging. Next, I want to color these segments because at the moment, if I leave these, they're actually still kind of weird shapes. They're not kind of sliced up yet. To slice them up, I've got them all selected with my black arrow, shape builder. I'm going to pick a fill color, any fill color. We're going to change this in a second. Oops, click off. And if I click on this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, just alternating patterns. I'm going to pick another fill. Yep. Now, watch this. They should all be separate segments. Okay, and now I can go through and recolor them. And what I'll first do is select them, grab the stroke, say no stroke, buddy. Zoom out so I can see my colors at the top here. I'm gonna use my eyedropper tool to select the colors. So I'm gonna select this first chunk and eyedropper tool and click the middle. Okay, black arrow, this one, eyedropper tool, this one. Now, oh, wrong one. Okay, shortcuts, V key is the move tool, okay, which we just used, click on this. I is the eyedropper tool, okay, V key. Look how impressed you are with my shortcuts. I'm trying to go real fast. It's taking forever, Dan. Come on. I'm trying to impress the people. All right, we're getting there. Cool, so that's one way of doing the heart, right? And let's look at a second way, because maybe you're looking for like perfect geometry. Now first up, we're gonna start with the rectangle tool. We're gonna draw out a rough rectangle size. We're also gonna grab the line segment tool here and just click hold and drag. Now remember, if I hold shift, then it comes a straight line. I'm gonna select both of these guys and go to align vertical horizontal. I can never remember, horizontal. Okay, and so I've got this. Now next thing I wanna do is I want to rotate this around. I could use my controls over here, but I'm just gonna hover just out here with my black arrow, hold shift, start dragging, and it should lock it into the kind of ratio that I need. Now I'm gonna kind of move it around this sort of way. Now if yours is the wrong size, mine just magically was the right size, okay? Click on just this, and you can adjust the sides here pretty easily. If you have them both selected and try to adjust the sides, it kind of does weird stuff. So have it off, go in here, and adjust it to be perfect. If yours is jumping around like mine, trying to snap to things, you might want to turn view smart guides off for a second and turn it back on. I'm happy with that. Next I want to do is make this rounded curve at the top here, and it's using these little dots. Now if you drag one of them, okay, black arrow, just got the rectangle selected, it does both sides, which might work for me. I can just slide it down. Okay, what you can do is you can grab the white arrow, click this guy and hold shift and grab that one and just do these two at the top here, up to you. I'm gonna slide it down. Because it's 45 degrees, it's really easy. I just start dragging it, okay? And if I hold shift, just kind of slides it down at 45 degree angle. Line it up either which way, okay? And yeah, that's gonna be the basics of it. We're gonna select this one. We're gonna copy it, and we did reflect before. Let's just rotate this one. You gotta copy it first, so go to edit and go to copy, and then there's one in here that says paste in place. Now I've just got two copies right over top of each other, okay, and I want this top one to be rotated over. Now I'm just using my arrow key, okay, just to kind of tap it around to get it kind of looking like it should. And we're kind of back to that exact same first spot. So I'm gonna run through it now, but yeah, we're up to the same spot where we go into our magical shape builder tool. Bye, bye, bye. So I'm holding on the alt key. I'm gonna kind of alternately fill these guys with green, just so they're all sliced up. Okay, actually I don't need to go and fill the other ones up, I don't think, because they should all be separate pieces, they are. Great, select them all, black arrow. I'm going to go to the stroke, no stroke please. And let's go to, actually it's a little bit hard with no stroke, okay, because these guys don't have a fill. So select the edge of them if you followed me, or just give them a fill. Okay, and I'm gonna steal the colors from this because it's easy. Remember the I on your keyboard is for the eyedropper, the V for the move tool or the selection tool. And I'm just gonna go around, V key to select it, I key, rob color, V key, select it. Come on, can't select it because it's got no edge. Definitely color it. Go I key, select it. V key, select it, I tool, select the colors. Don't listen to me, I'm rambling. All right, eHarmony. Now let's look at the text here. Okay, we're not gonna redraw it with the pen tool. What we're gonna draw is we're gonna zoom in on an example of it, okay, that we were using as a demo. I'm gonna do a screenshot, Command Shift 4 on a Mac, or print screen on a PC. What I'm looking for is I'm gonna go to typekit.com, and I'm gonna try and find that shortcut screenshot. On a Mac, it ends up on your desktop. PC, I'm really not too sure where it goes. You might have to check where your screenshots end up. So I'm gonna drag this in, and hopefully Typekit's gonna find it. What I probably should do is Google what eHarmony uses as their new font, okay? So this is a new logo redesign for them for 2017. And yep, it's picked a single line of text. Thank you very much. I need to confirm the text. They've guessed it perfectly. If it's wrong, you can just type it in. Now it's looking for the font, okay? And Looks pretty close. The big one here is the A. Okay, you see here, some fonts actually have within their font two versions of the A, so be careful there. You might think it's not the right font, but it is, and you just got to go into the glyphs panel in Photoshop. Now, what probably the biggest giveaway is this little slice here, and this A here has got a bit of an accent here. That might be something that the logo designers have done intentionally, okay, taken a font like this and then gone and adjusted it. So I made the font size bigger, you saw there, just so I can go down scrolling. I'm looking for the A first of all, because that's the dead giveaway. And none of those ones, because now I'm looking at the E. It's none of those ones either. Okay, you get what the process is here. If it says sync, which is awesome, it means it's free. It's part of Typekit and part of your subscription. If it says pay, it's one of the paid fonts. All right, let's jump back into Illustrator. Let's look at our handiwork. One handiwork. This is probably more accurate. This one here was a little bit of a guess. Okay, but they both came out pretty good. All right, I hope you learned some stuff. And yeah, let's get on to the next video course in Adobe Illustrator. Hi, what did you think of the video? If you enjoyed it, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also, leave me a comment. Let me know what you liked about it. Also, this is kind of a short part of a longer course. Okay, if you want to check that out, it's at bringyourownlaptop.com. This is the Essentials course. Okay, there is also another course. There is an Advanced course, okay, for Illustrator, and also a UI web app design version of Illustrator course as well. Check all those out. Also, it's quite a visual course. I'd love to see what you've actually made. On Instagram, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop. Okay, check that out. Also, remember there's a cheat sheet you can download. Bring your own laptop. It's free under resources. Check all that out. And yeah, I'll see you in another video. Bye now.